very good morning to the faculty present here and a warm welcome to all my dear friends who have come here to attend this session today. Now, coming to today's session, it is a review on Indian Budget 2020. As we all know, we from the past 2 days, since the Indian Budget has been released, we have tried hard and we have made a review and a survey along with our faculty members and all the finance professors who were present in the our department. We have done a survey and review regarding this, and today we are going to present what are all the things that we have learned through it, and we wanted to share some of them through it. As we all know that there are two people who are present during the Indian Budget release session. They are the State Minister Anurag Thakur and the Cabinet Minister Nirmala Sitharaman. As she came to present the budget, she came with a red bag in her hand, which is called Bai Katha, which means a ledger to account. And the main theme of this budget is ease of living. And there are three prominent things that she concentrated as a result of this budget. They are aspirational India, economical development, and a caring society. These are the three prominent things that we know. Now, we all may have a question that why do we need to review this academy, as we all know what has already happened. The thing is that being the grads, being the pillars to the future generation, we need to understand what is going in our country. Whatever we need to do, any job, name it a startup, name it a business, name it a HR manager, finance manager, marketing manager, which we are going to step into the outside world, we need to know what is going in our country, in our state, in our surrounding places. So we need to clearly understand what these figures mean, right? We need to understand what these figures, what the increase, decrease, what this taxing, what is this LIC, IPOs and all that. So we are here to discuss regarding all this, and at the end or in the middle, if you have any doubts, name it anything related to business, IPOs, related to your jobs, career or whatever, you can pose us the questions and we'll be giving you answers. This is a brief introduction about what are we going to do in this session. For today's session, I would also like to add that there are two resource people. One is Dr. Sanyas Raju sir and Dr. Raju Indupuri sir.
Here to discuss the Indian Budget 2020, the Indian economy, you can see that it was going a slowdown nowadays. What the government is taking to, what measures is taking to again to boom the economy and to maintain the economic growth which is continuing from the past decade. Like the economy was growing for like 7% like that. But the economy from past years it was slowed down to 4%. And the global economy was also decreasing its pace to increase. So that the Indian budget we have concentrated, like coming to the first slide, the Modi government has done many things, like they were concentrated on more the agriculture sectors, like to develop the bottom-up approach, and they were not taking any big reforms, but big bang reforms, but they were concentrated more on many sectors to develop the economy. Stock markets were not happy that there were the stock market traded separately for the day, Saturday, but the stock market was not so happy. The stock market was decreased to 2.5% slump. And economic survey was gone before day, like budget on 31st January. It was also given many recommendations to the government to develop the policy changes. Coming to the third slide, like class force. The tax revenue coming to the Indian government is 16,35,909 crores, and the other receipts is 3,84,387 crores. The total receipts is 2020, it is the year 296. And total expenditure is 30,042 lakhs and 42,230,000. Fiscal deficit is 7,796,337. And fiscal deficit is 3.5%. It was increased last year from past year to this year, and is growing to increase like 3.8%. Like, and the personal income tax changes we were mainly discussed in the Indian financial budget 2020. The income tax was introduced in new slab system by 7 reforms. They were introduced the 7 slab systems. In the past, there were only 4 slab systems. But in the present 2020 budget, they have written to 7. The new scheme for beneficial for low income people, what the new slabs were introduced. And the personal slab income tax was introduced from 2 lakhs. There was no income tax for people who are earning below the 2,50,000. And there was 5% tax for increasing incrementally up to the 15 lakhs thousand who are earning. After 15 lakhs, there was surcharge also applicable. You can see that new tax system, like 0 to 2,50,000, there was no tax at all. And from 2,50,000 to 5 lakhs, there was 5% of tax. And for 5 lakhs, 1 rupee to 7,50,000, there was 10%, it was decreased. In the past, it was 20%, but present, it was 10%. Like that, for up to 15 lakhs, there was 30% of slab system was maintained, kept by this government. In the investor perspective, we can say that FPA, foreign portfolio investments, was increased to 15% in the corporate ones. Past was 9%. And the bank deposit insurance, it was from 1 lakh to 5 lakhs. It was increased from 1 lakh to 5 lakhs. Like you can say that in the past, if we deposit money in the bank, we will get an insurance of only 1 lakh. But from now, we will get 5 lakhs from the insurance. It was based on the PMC bank. PMC Bank for Fallnet, which is Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank, which is went to fraudulent in the nowadays, we can see in the news. And 100% tax exemption on sovereign wealth funds. Like it is for the foreign players to invest in India and to make India develop in infrastructure sectors. And also, equity linked savings scheme ELFCC and security equity mutual funds tax saving under LTC systematic investment plan. This was the taking down because the premium exemption was taken away from the income tax department. And more soft and 100% tax benefits are given in the sovereignty wealth fund. This will boost the infrastructure development in India. Financial markets. In ETFs, government securities for retail and pension funds, debt ETFs were introduced in the new budget. It is called in the Bharat Bond. It was successful in the past year. So the debt ETFs were also introduced to grow, boom the economy. And rupee derivatives are traded in the GIFT City of Gujarat. It is one of the international financial service centers which is established near Ahmedabad. And also international bullion exchange was established in GIFT City to develop the gold trade in India. Dividend distribution tax is one of the major components in the stock markets. Dividend distribution tax is the company is paying the dividends to the shareholders. It was directly transferred to the investors. So that the investors should pay double tax like income tax and the dividend which is getting on to the them from the company. From 2020, it was shared to the like investors will get the more money in their pocket based on their income. The income tax slab is levied on them. And next is for continued by Roshan.
Coming to the MSMEs, budget 2020 has allocated 900 crores to the debt funding for the MSMEs. Audit and test board has increased from 1 crore to 5 crores. And the finance minister, Nirmala Sitharaman, announced a range of schemes for MSMEs and small industries that is constantly growing and keeping the wheels of our economy moving forward. Okay, when coming to the regional distribution, the Nirmala Sitharaman has proposed a new airport of 22, which is confined to the north, but for south, there will be no special status for the Andhra Pradesh, and as well as no railway zone for Visakhapatnam. And now, Dr. Indipuri sir and Bhaskar sir will just start a Q&A session regarding this topic. Bhaskar sir will pose some questions to Indrapuri sir, and sir will be addressing it. After that, students will just ask the questions, and you can ask any questions if you have any things to know about the budget.
So I'm here as a catalyst to just ask more questions, and basically we want the students to ask questions because this is a place where we can learn, and being management students, it's our duty to learn. So to begin with, we may not know what it's all about, but at least at the end of this session, we hope that the students who are going out of this class will have some understanding about what is this budget 2020 is all about. Thank you, sir, for this opportunity. I would like to begin with a very simple question. Like we have this Bahi Katha.
Okay.
So why it is called the Bahi Katha and what it is?
Bahi Katha is a Sanskrit or Indian or Hindi word. Bahi is open, Katha is accounts. It's an open account book. The budget is prepared on confidential documents, where it is an inflow and outflow of all the revenues, receipts and other receipts like revenue and expenditure for the coming financial year. So the bunch of papers are carried to the parliament to take the permission of the parliament so that the government can spend further. That is the idea. So it's now it's known as Bahi Katha.
Thank you, sir. As I ask questions, you can think about the questions which you are presented, and you can also ask questions. Okay. And sir, in the presentation of budget, why it is so important? Why this budget? Like everybody is so eager to look at this budget. How it is going to make a difference?
Actually, budget has nothing to do with the media. And budget is slowly losing its, what slowly, it's already lost its economic sense. Budget is an economic tool, it's a financial planning tool, but because of the media and the way they're politicizing it, it is slowly becoming a political flavor, so it has become in the headlines. And you would have seen there is nothing for the media right now to talk about the budget. And there are no hitting headlines. The reason here is earlier, GST, before GST, everything was there on budget. So what is costly, what is cheaper, you know, everything used to hit the headlines. Now GST is given and everything is known, nothing to talk about those things in budget. So even media is worried, there is no big bang reforms, you know, there is no benchmarking, there is no budget was boring kind of thing. Why? Because fuel prices, they are left to the market. GST is already given, so nothing to share. That is how media tries to catch, and now it is not happy with the budget. Any budget will be like this. I can say this is a typical Modi style budget, because Modi doesn't want to hit the whole country on one day. If he wants to give, let it be demonetization or GST, he gives on any day. He doesn't wait for the budget. He gives it on the day whenever he prefers.
Sir, regarding the e-commerce business, there is a 1% tax on TDS. Like regarding the e-commerce business, there was a tax on 1% like on TDS, like tax deduction on source, 1%. What? How is this affecting the e-commerce business?
Corporate business in the tax brackets. If you take Flipkart or kind of big people, but the people who are selling their things on e-portals, okay. The seller who is getting it, what he is selling, what she is selling, you know, there could be some capital gain added, value added to that. So now slowly, you know, Modi is like a typical Gujarati Modi, he looks for money, he doesn't leave anyone. So he is looking for more tax sources. The problem here is, Modi has cut the corporate tax rate from 32% down to 22%. Yeah, we all have to understand it. And he thought the revenue will increase. More people will produce it, but unfortunately the target corporate tax was not met. He is finding for more clues. So e-commerce, some TDS tax source from that is the idea. That's how Nirmala Sitharan eyed on this.
So that education says like that, which is hilarious. Now it is standing at 4%, if I'm not wrong.
Even earlier also it is 4%.
It was like initially when it began, it was 2% and then 3% and then it is 4%. Is it that government is spending more on education? Is it because of
that is very difficult to trace out. But as I already said just now, let it be Modi government or NDA government or UPA government or any government, they want money. So when I was young, there was no service tax. Then 1% service tax was introduced. Then it became 2. Then it became 5. Then it became 10. Now education says started with 1%. Now it has reached 4%. It may reach beyond that also. It is a surcharge on the tax. Just to make understand, it is not a tax. It is a surcharge on the tax collected. 100 rupees is the tax. 4% on 100 rupees. So 104 has to be paid by the tax.
While presenting the budget by Nirmala Sitharaman, it reflects share market prices. Why it reflects?
Media is number one to take the highlights. You know, nothing to Andhra Pradesh. You know, nothing to steel industry. Nothing to whoever has lost their highlight to blame the government. Similarly, stock market always responds. I am very active in derivatives. I always take call option. Long position, put option, long position. I always take these two positions. If market swings upward or downward, I make money. But those days are gone. Thanks to Modi, it doesn't give the big things, big bang things on budget day. No big economic reform is given on budget day. He gives or he plans on his own day. But as you're asking, surprisingly, the budget has the B day markets were negative. Sensex has lost close to 1000 points. It is the biggest fall in a single day for the past 10 years. That was a surprise to me. Why? Because they didn't say anything about FPIs. There's nothing on securities transaction tax, nothing. It was there last year. They didn't respond. But still, maybe the problem is economic survey has given or hinted. There is a slowdown. What is that you are trying? They proved. One has to understand that. There is an importance for economic survey and budget followed by summary of budget or budget at glance followed by budget speech by finance minister. These four things are there. But unfortunately, the persons or the ministry who prepared the budget, they ignored economic survey. Economic survey given by a chief economic advisor, he clearly mandated that we are rolling into recessionary tendencies. So what are the packages government is planning? So I think there is no mention about it. Surprisingly, Nirmala Sitharaman said that we are going to have 10%+ of normal nominal GDP growth rate. I was surprised, I was shocked to see that. I think opposition parties are laughing at her. I don't know why she gave that.
We are studying it.
Yeah, this is not the time to talk about GDP growth rate. This is the time to talk about packages. You know, SOPs, tax SOPs or whatever.
To boost the economy.
Yeah, to consumption demand should go up. Industry should be happy. More loans should be taken.
Maybe I think that is the reason why the stock market has reacted negatively.
Maybe, yeah.
That they are looking for some boosters.
That was not dealt. That was not touched at all. No, if you don't touch, we will see the sellers. Importantly, FDIs with institutional sellers, they shedded off some sector shares. That's what we have. Yeah.
After the announcement of new budget, the share market is giving a negative effect. It means it's falling down. What is the reason behind that?
And we just discussed about it. And Sahil also concluded. Maybe the whole, please be seated. The whole market is expecting some packages or some worrying things about a slowdown or something, but nothing was touched. Nirmala Sitharam didn't talk anything about it. That could be the reason.
My question was regarding personal income tax.
Okay.
She just manipulated the figures.
Yeah.
She has reduced. She has put two tax bracket options.
Yeah.
Either the old one or you follow the new one. Majority of the what is called as job firms expected that because of higher inflation rate, higher cost, they thought that up to 10 lakh, okay, it will be zero. Okay, from 10 lakh to the next bracket started. What she has done is, she has reduced that marginal percentage. Means previously it's 10, now reduced to 5, previously 20, reduced to 15, 20, 25. And people also expected that. The savings bracket, that is 150,000 rupees per month, what the government is giving as a savings, it is not at all enough for a middle class man or a common man.
Yeah.
They thought it would be expected to increase by 1 lakh, 2 lakh 50 or up to 3 lakh rupees. That has not been also done. So the common man, regarding the common man, I'm talking about the common man.
We are common man.
Because they are the highest taxpayers.
Yeah.
So they felt very bad about the budget regarding their personal consumption. actually is really benefit, sir, to follow those two tax brackets? It is benefit for the common man or for the government?
Yeah. Actually, for the past 3 days, I worked on it personally. The whole country is in confusion about that. Importantly, taxpayers like me, who are the bakras, you know, we are very honest. We can't escape tax, and our employer squeezes taxes from us in advance, which is tagged as TDS. Okay. All the taxpayers have advantage of this new flat tax regime given by Nirmala Sitharaman. Perfectly, you have the advantage. I will tell you how it happens. Earlier, different tax slabs were there: 0%, 5%, 20%, 30%, and so on. Now she made it very clean and simple. How she has done is, tax slab is a multiple of 2.5 lakhs. 0 to 2.5, 5 lakhs, 7.5, 10, 12.5, 15. That's it. 0 to 15, 2.5 lakhs tax slab. Above 15 lakhs, there's nothing. Tax rate or whatever is flat. Then what is happening to this tax rate in these labs? 0 to 2.5, 0%. 2.5 to 5 lakhs, 5%. 5 lakh to 7.5, it is
10%.
So incremental tax slab of 2.5 lakhs, incremental tax rate of 5%. 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30. That is maximum. So as Professor Kalyan is asking, his question is, what is the benefit, if I am not wrong? Should we stick to the existing tax plan or the new one? All the taxpayers have to shift to the new tax regime. Why am I telling you? The benefits under 80G or 80C or 87A, whatever, the maximum you get is 5 lakhs. Maximum you get is 5 lakhs. So, even for example, I am not using any tax exemptions. Sir is using maximum. Okay? Or both the sirs are using maximum. The person who uses maximum tax exemptions will get less benefit. A person like me who is not using a tax benefit at all will get the maximum. The maximum is 78,000, a person like me. Even if you are using the tax exemptions with the old regime, you will get the benefit if you shift the new tax regime to an extent of 67,000. So it is advised to shift the new tax regime. And already for the financial year 2021, 70 items which are deductions or exemptions are benefit, they are removed. 21, 22, everything will be removed. So you have the benefit. It is easy to file, easy to understand. You will have absolute advantage if you shift to the new tax regime. I hope I answered your question. Yeah, Pascal?
Previously, if you go for old one, I saw the table. If you are paying 90,000, currently you are getting from 15,000 to 16,000.
Exactly. 67,000. Correct. Exactly. What he said is, sir said is right. 90,000 minus 30,000 something you said. Difference is 67, because you are using the tax benefits. If you are not using that, maximum 78,000 you will get that. Yeah.
Coming to sovereign wealth fund, we observed that there is a 100% tax exemption on sovereign wealth fund. How do you think would that affect the economy or the source of income to our country?
Yeah, first of all, I am so happy for the investors. Retail investors, all financial literacy is zero in India. I should say that. Okay? Let it be insurance or mutual funds. Direct participation, no one does in debt market. Okay? So when 100% tax exemption on sovereign wealth funds. So whatever you get, even if you, I should tell about DDT first before I talk about
maybe,
this.
Maybe you can explain first, what is that sovereign debt fund?
Yeah, sovereign debt fund is the mutual fund which invests its own money collected in sovereign bonds, government securities, or G6 or G securities, which is known as. So if there is a fund which has invested all of its money in sovereign funds, 100% tax exemption. Not only that, foreign portfolio investors, FPI's limit in these funds is raised from 9% to 15%. That is also a good move. So why it is advantageous, I should tell about DDT, dividend distribution tax. If a shareholder or unit holder gets dividend from mutual fund or bonds or equity shares, that is double taxed. How it is double taxed? Straight away, for example, if you take mutual fund, it is taxed at 11.3% around, I'm not sure about it. And moreover, the net amount is added to my personal income, that where I should meet my personal income tax also. But now there is no DDT. And debt funds, if I get a dividend on debt fund, it is taxed close to 30%, 29% plus. Now it is not there. DDT is not there. Whether it is equity fund or debt fund from mutual funds or dividends paid by share from shares, there is no DDT at all. So wins to the investors or shareholders. They are more happy. Investors should be happy. Am I clear? Sure? Yeah. Sir, sir?
Sir, is this a people's budget or for political growing budget?
That's what I was saying when Bhaskar sir was asking something. Budget has nothing to do with people or politics or public administration. First thing, it is pure economics. It is a media coinage. People's budget, election budget, kind of thing. But those things will come before the elections, not now.
Okay, election budget definitely we have.
Definitely they try to attract more tax ops for farmers, whoever has a more voting percentage. They will be getting more tax ops.
Sir, agriculture budget is divided from union budget.
No. Agriculture, it's not agriculture budget. Right? Agriculture sectoral allocation is given in budget. How much is allocated kind of?
Railway budget is different from
Railway budget is railway budget. Modi government has dissolved railway budget as separate budget. Like as you said, allocation for agriculture, they also talk about railway.
Is this useful dividing the railway budget to union budget?
No, not at all. If someone cannot manage, it is needed. If you can, it's up to you.
Sir, why government selling LIC shares to private sector? 10% of shares.
Yeah, so again there is a confusion, there is a lot of debates. People who hate Modi government or NDA government, people who support UPA kind of thing, it is taking that flavor, again political flavor. Okay? But as a management student, as a finance professor, we are here to talk about it. So instead of using the word LIC is selling, LIC is sold, LIC is for sale, that's not correct. Air India is for sale. You can use that word. Okay? In LIC, what happens is, for example, if you take Maruti Udyog Limited, it came for public issue in 2003. It is completely owned by Indian government. They didn't sell Maruti Udyog Limited. They came for IPO with an intention to give shares to public. Product didn't change, management didn't change, ownership didn't change. Are you getting my point? But if you take Air India case, yeah, ownership is going to change. Earlier, partly majority of the stake is open for sale for private aviation, including foreigners. But now government is saying, already said before budget, I'm saying, Chandu, he's saying 100% stake will be given to anyone. So they're selling outright. But in the case of LIC, it's not the scenario. Okay? Like 2018, GIC Reinsurance came for public issue. Some stake of it is one of the world's biggest reinsurance company, GIC. So they sold some stake in GIC. Similarly, and even in Maruti Udyog Limited, LIC is government, central government through budget said that in second half of financial year 2021 will start the process of selling some equity stake. That is 5% or 10%, we don't know. That is for the public, not for private people or private car. It is not for sale for ICICI or HDFC or some other. It is a public issue.
Is IW an investor?
That is the other part. You have to be very careful. Right? People are... the question should be the other way. Sir, LIC is for sale. Like we lost our money in GIC. Investors lost their money. It is overvalued. These people will overvalue. 100 rupees worth of share will be offered for 200 or 300. Definitely. That's for sure. Be careful with the valuation. Don't think LIC is good. But LIC is good. It's a good company for investors. Because all deposits, assets, premiums, policies of publics with LIC are supported and backed by government. Okay? So till that point of time, value is there, but it should not be overpriced. Investors should be careful. If it is lower price, you go ahead for the IPO. If it is overpriced, please don't do that. Yeah. Yeah, Padmavati?
Yes, so is this budget a boom to your manufacturing
sector? Budget didn't talk specifically about tax talks to one sector. That's what I had been telling. They gave in general, maybe the only highlight thing is personal income tax. Apart from that, nothing is there. So manufacturing sector, they already got the benefit last year when corporate tax was cut down from 32% to 22%. That's a big boon for the manufacturing sector. They have to make a benefit out of it. Yes, it already happened before the budget.
Sir, as the economy was slowed down, the Indian government want to increase the purchasing power of the people.
Yeah.
Regarding to personal tax, personal income tax, up to 5 lakhs earning people, they are the people who are occupying India most.
Okay.
Like you are saying that 1% or 2% of the people are having the more money in Indian economy.
Okay.
The middle class people are having the more people with less than 5 lakhs of income annually. The Indian government what is done is more than 10 lakhs they have decreased the taxes for the people. That like rich is becoming rich and the middle class people was no tax exemptions were given for them. Like tax exemptions was given but how they were taken many tax exemptions under 80s.
What is the question?
Now, how it is benefit to the common man?
Which one?
The new tax slab system.
I think I already explained Kalyan. You have to see 0 to 2.5, old one, 0 to 2.5, new one. Okay? Apply the tax rates. You see the difference. I told you there is a difference of 78,000 as benefit if your income is 15 lakhs. Similarly, you check for 10 lakhs or 5 lakhs or 2.5 lakhs. At every level, there is a benefit. At every level, there is a benefit. You can check that. So, obviously, and 78,000 rupees per year if you are in the 15 lakh income category. So as you are talking about slowdown, you have, what does people do with the surplus money saved through taxes? They don't try to save, they try to spend it. That's the reason they are given this option of tax benefit. Though they didn't say that, they wanted to give some savings to the taxpayers to a maximum extent of 78,000. A minimum with all the tax exemptions used in comparison, 67,000. That is the benefit you will be getting. And where it will go? Oh, I saved 67,000. Let me buy something. Let me buy something for my wife, for my husband, for my kids. Something like that, you will do it. That boost. And one has to understand, it's not the recession, recession, recession. These are the words coined by media. Okay, whether internally something is there or not, that is different. The way media makes the things, you know, China is in trouble. Because of its trade war, China is in trouble. Coronavirus, China is in trouble. If China is in trouble, media says, if you hit India, come on, let's pull your socks. You know, let's do something. If America has a problem, they hint us. They have to hint Americans, Chinese, not Indians. Definitely some influence is there. If you take 2008 recession, it didn't influence the whole economy. IT related, forex, foreign export related were heavily hit. But rest of things are fine. I hope you are getting my point. So you have to see India separately, even if it is a slowdown or some other economic crisis.
Like what I was trying to say is what presently media is projecting. You don't need to be panic about it. Oh, India, something is happening like that. Certain sector may be affected, but it's not the overall country may be affected.
Because they want readers. If there is an earthquake, if 15 people lost their life, they put it as 1500. They don't mind. They want people to read. Right? There is nothing to write every day about stock market. Every day, stock market has lost 10,000 crores. And you put all the things together, that is nothing, but still they are right.
Sir,
yeah.
Indian budget was made always in deficit.
Sorry?
Indian budget was made always in deficit.
Yeah. Maybe this again, we feel that Indian budget is like that. Any country's budget is like that. Not Indian, you take Chinese or Vietnam or Pakistan or Sri Lanka, American. Any budget will be deficit. The idea is governments have borrowing capacity. They can get their own money. It is easy to raise money from the public. Or they can fill the gap. There are n number of ways. We can get into monetary economics also for that. We can discuss that later. So budget should be in deficit. Why? Because public expenditure should be there. How to? Because government is not doing business. You have to understand. If you look at Middle East, UAE kind of governments, yes, they can't dare to show losses, which is deficit. They should have more income than expenditure. But in Indian kind of thing, where we have a mixed economy, you know, socialist or sovereign or a kind of society-oriented economy, spendings are always expected. So you don't dare to expect our budget to be surplus. It will be there in deficit.
Stock ownership, employee stock ownership has got 5 years tax holiday.
I'm sorry to stop you. No one is talking about MSMEs. I'm expecting my students to do startups and become entrepreneurs instead of waiting for offer letter, who will give kind of thing. You know, for you there is a good news. A lot of things are there. I think Roshni has already given out. One is ESOP. ESOPs, employee stock options, the time that they hold, the period was enhanced to 5 years. So till that point of time, they need not pay the tax. 5 years, our employee leaves the organization, or employee sells ESOPs, whichever is first, will be taxed. That will be the duration time. Not only that, the audit turnover limit has been enhanced to more than 1 crore. If your turnover is 1 crore, you have to go for auditing. That got enhanced. That's also good news. Not only that, even NBFCs are invited to fund startups or MSMEs for a kind of invoice funding kind of thing can be. Now it's open for NBFCs also. There are more for NBFCs, but no media is writing about it. It is so good for the NBFCs, MSMEs. But no media is writing about it.
Sir, is this amount allocated for example, we allocated some amount to agriculture.
Mm-hmm.
Is this spending that money, whatever it allocating the money, is spending correctly or not?
Yeah, I think Chandu was, what did you ask, reality? No, something else someone is asking. Reality, it is very difficult to check whether it happened or not. As Hariprasad are asking, sectoral allocations will always be there. Targets will be there. But it really happens or not, that's a big question mark.
Sir, if it happens, there is no farmer's reset, for example.
No, let me complete. First of all, allocation is just a number. Okay? That's the reason we have budget, revised budget, actuals. Three will be there. Budget proposal is for the acceptance in the parliament. Then, after a few months or few quarters, it will be revised. Then at the end of the financial year, it will be
actual.
You can compare these three. For the financial year 1920, you had budget proposal, revised, BERE. If you go through Economic Times or Business Value, you will find BE and RE. BE is budget estimates. RE is revised estimates. Then you also have actuals. You can check all these three. You will get the information. I'll tell you an example. Last year, he is asking about LIC. Last year, disinvestment objective or target is 1 lakh 4 crores. They hardly could meet 20,000 disinvestment. Now they have doubled it. They are saying the target has 2 lakh 8 crores. 8,000 crores. So they are just numbers. You have to check whether it is there or not.
Sir, every year they are focusing on agriculture infrastructure. But why
the
agriculture and infrastructure budget is not reaching to the people? It means farmers.
Infrastructure?
And agriculture.
Okay, maybe. I think it's almost the same question. it is what, where does the money go? What it is our public money. It is we have paid the taxes. It is public money. On behalf of us, NDA government or UPA government is using. Where did you use your money? Where did you keep it? Did you misuse? Did you properly use? For that, the biggest thing is agriculture. Biggest thing is infrastructure. Okay? These are the two things. Loan repayment, they will not say. That is also biggest. Very big. They will not talk about it. But as you both are asking, yeah, I got benefited by allocations. I got benefited by infrastructure. Infrastructure means spending on roads, telecommunications, so on. But the realities were tested with the numbers given by finance minister in the parliament. That's where opposition comes into the picture. Okay? Ruling party will not talk about actual numbers of the budget. Opposition talks about that. But speaker may not give that much time to talk about the actuals.
So just to answer both of your questions, we know that budget is a plan. When you say budget, it is a proposed plan, isn't it?
Yeah, exactly, it's a plan.
How it is actually implemented, that we have to discuss once it is implemented. So last year's budget, how it was implemented, that you can answer last year. This was allocated, but this was spent. Why the gap? Then the government has to answer. But this is the budget proposed for this year. So it's a plan.
Yeah.
From the past 2 days since this budget is released, there is a saying that for people who are really saving money, who wanted to save money, there is no use. Is it true? What do you feel that if I want to save some amount of money due to this income tax, personal income tax savings and all, there is no use for me? What do you feel? Is that real?
No, first of all, who said that?
In the public, when three or four people are gathered and discussed about budget, this is the first point they are raising. That they have cancelled the income tax on savings, right? So they were telling that if I take a house loan, I can't show that as tax exemption. So I can't, there's no use that whether I save the money or not. So okay. My doubt is it true if I save something, will I get tax? I won't get tax exemption. So that it affects my savings. Is that true or not?
I'll just answer in principle and answer detail. For any economy, if you take for example American economy, we say that it's going because of the consumption, but they always encourage consumption. American economy discourages savings. And as India, we always follow the America for everything. This is one strategy we try to adopt for discouraging savings. Because when it is saved in a bank or in your house, sometimes we don't even keep it in bank. Many of the Indians, we have the habit of keeping that in the house. So it is an inactive money. It becomes a non-performing asset. It is not working. It is not doing any improvement function for the economy. But once when the money goes to the market, when it goes to the industry, then it multiplies. It produces. So as an organizer, I mean as a government, I always want the money to circulate in the economy. I don't want it to be static. So that's why I always encourage consumption, not savings. So that is in principle, that is the...
Okay, I think partially sir has answered, but he has given valid points. I got two questions from you. Sir is clearly saying that, American economy is the best example. They are mad of spending. On the weekends, they don't spend, they die. That's not life. You know, they're not happy. In many of my sessions, sir, I was saying that. Okay? The reason here is, if there should be production, there should be an increase in demand. Demand should go up. Yes, sir? Demand should go up. And if the demand goes up, production demand goes up, requirement for production goes up, then people will call for money. Then whatever you are talking about savings, that will come into the picture. Okay? But both have to happen. It's not that if you are looking only for one side, I think if the economy or the government is pressurizing the people to spend, not to save, you are getting into debt trap. That's quite dangerous when economy comes into recession, people lose jobs at the micro level. So, savings are also important. And as you are saying, there are two questions, should I save or not, number one. Number two is, I'm not attracted to take home loan. So, first of all, savings is your choice. If you want to save or spend, definitely savings are there. It is your choice. Like I told you, Nirmala Sitharaman's intention to give a maximum of 78,000 surplus or whatever is to make people spend. Even Moti is also like that. Oh, I saved 78,000, let me spend. Okay, it's your choice to save or spend. But there is a problem here. Insurance and home loans, these two got the attention of every common man only because of the tax benefit. If there is no tax benefit, there will be no demand for housing and there will be no boom in real estate or construction or whatever. So if these things are taken away, they are not saying we are taking out, we will gradually phase out. But indirectly saying, please switch to this. Indirectly they are saying that. If this happens, I think the social priorities, a common man, though he doesn't have a money or she doesn't have a money, they dare to buy a house. Okay? So that culture will fade out. Maybe with me, with you, it's fine. But next generation, they may lose this kind of flavor. That is the biggest problem if that is taken out. I hope I answered your question. So that's a problem. It is hitting the society not to buy. Means it comes that if you have money, you buy home. If you don't have money, don't buy.
I have an observation that planned expenditure and unplanned expenditure,
yeah,
is it part of the budget?
Yes. Yes.
So, many times I observed that the unplanned expenditure is more than the planned expenditure. So, I feel it should be like, when we should plan it. Is it like, by design, is it like that or?
Yeah. See, the public administration is so dynamic. Governance, or you call it as, it is very tough to do it. It changes day-to-day basis or hourly basis also, you never know. So planned expenditure, it's all about revenue receipts and revenue spendings. For example, you have taken loans. Yeah, you have to pay interest. You have public expenditure for all public sector, public offices and so on. So you know those commitments, very clear. But that is planned. Unplanned things you don't know. So it does not mean that every year it happens, but it happens, definitely it is more than this. So why? Because it is unplanned, we don't know. And to establish it, to plan it, to estimate itself, that becomes a problem. That's how it happens.
Sir, for the e-commerce, they has proposed 1% TDS. How will the sellers affect due to this?
I think that was already asked, somebody asked. It was answered.
Sir, initially what you have mentioned, this is budget is only for economic assets. But I'm asking the question, why the government schemes or UPS schemes or NDA schemes is included in this budget?
You're talking about in this budget specific or in general?
In this budget or general? Whatever.
In this budget, what is added?
For example, we see the PM Gram Sadak Yojana or something, schemes are there. But why this is
it's part of infrastructure. It's just a name given to the plan, that's all.
But this is related to NDA's political schemes. I think if we allocated more than crores to...
No, if it is NDA or UPA, if it is for the infrastructure of a village or suburban area or town or city, it is infrastructure. Name could be different. But as you were asking earlier, if it is implemented or not, we have to cross-check. As Sarvaj was also asking, he started, it's an opener. 4% education says, he said. So the idea is to spend more money in the education sector. That is the idea. But to what extent they have done or not, we have to cross check. Swachh Bharat says, to what extent the money is used for clean and neatness or discipline in the public places. That we have to cross check. Government says that, but opposition has condemned it. You have to understand one thing, I already told you, budget speech is different from budget. You also have a budget summary or budget at glance. Budget speech is a rosy picture. Even I was deceived when I was listening to Nirmala Sitharaman. Okay? 0 to 5 lakhs, she said no tax. She started tax from 5 lakh onwards. She went till 15 lakhs. Oh, it is good. 0 to 5 lakhs, no tax. It is good, I felt happy. But after telling everything, narrating 78,000 sayings and everything, so 0 to 5 lakhs, it is similar to the old regime. 0 to 2.5 we don't have, and 2.5 to 5 lakhs we have 5%. That's how she concluded. So budget speech is a little deceiving. Any finance minister, not just Nirmala Sitharaman or Arun Jaitley or Chidambaram, anyone, it will be rosy. They try to appease everyone.
We are importing China products to India nearly 63%, sir. Due to some attack, viral attack, the entire exports and imports of China was been blocked there. Is the kind of impact was shown on the budgeting and as well as for the economy of India, any kind of impact?
Okay. No, people are yelling, people are asking me that sir, you ignored the budget, has ignored slowdown and so on. When we are ignoring our own things, we should be least bothered about it. Obviously, we never see this NDA government never cares about others. That's a good sign. They have self-belief, self-confidence, self-dependence. That's a very good thing to watch. Any developed economy, if you look at, that is an important trait. They are trying to do it. Internally, they are feeling or not, that's a different story. Okay? But impact of Chinese buying to Indian consumers or whatever, if you take electric vehicles. Electric vehicles is desperately needed. I hope you all agree with me. Okay? Electric vehicles have to be imported. It will be substituting the traditional cars. But the problem is domestic makers are hit. To support domestic players, what the finance minister has done is they have increased the duty on import of electric vehicles and the parts. Are you getting my point? Electric vehicles fully and parts to be assembled here through imports. They are discouraged by increasing or more import duties. Okay? So we are very strong on our own thing. I think companies like Tata Motors, they have launched SUV. I don't know how many of you have ever Mixer. Mixer, it is priced around 13 lakhs. I wish it will be a big hit in the coming months, quarters and years. Okay. The idea is to make Indian industry booming. Let us, the idea of making India concept is that only. Okay? Indirectly, they are inviting FDIs and FPS, but we also want our own money, our own people, our own brains here. Are you getting my point? In that case, see, earlier the whole world used to follow only US. Only US, no one else. But now, the one more brother, big brother came into the picture, China. Why? Because he is challenging Americans for everything. Let it be visas, let it be imports, let it be duties. No, they are challenging. So, everyone is watching America and China closely. They are strong, they are the biggest economies in terms of foreign trade or consumption or whatever. We are also close to them. The idea of NDA is that we are very close to them. Why are we talking about others? Okay? I don't know how many of you are aware, National Stock Exchange, NSE, has become world's biggest stock exchange in terms of number of trades. In terms of cash trades, it is number 3. You can cross check that. So thanks to this government making our own Indian things stronger and stronger. Am I harsh on you, Karthik? Did I answer you? Okay.
So the budget, there are more parameters you can follow the finance minister. In the back of finance minister, how many persons are worked in this asset? For example, there is any role play by any, for example.
Thanks for coming, sir. Economic survey is the base. Economic survey is the foundation done by Chief Economic Advisor, CEA. He does that, he assesses the whole data. For the actuals, I was telling you, R&B. I hope you remember. You guys remember that. Budget estimates, revised estimates, actuals. These three will be compared. And accordingly, what happened in the past 3 quarters? We are left out with one more quarter. In 3 quarters, what happened? Accordingly,
What are the problems? What has to be done? They clearly prescribe it. But this government has completely ignored chief economic surveys inputs. They didn't talk about the slowdown. They didn't talk about what are the packages kind of thing. That's where the media is bothered. They're hitting the headlines. That's how Sensex tanked close to 1000 points. They're unhappy. They thought they were talking about it. I hope I answered your questions.
The Moody's International Initiative gave the BBA2 rating to the Indian government, India sovereignty itself. How could it affect the like borrowing the external foreign money to India?
You're talking about sovereign ratings or borrowing ratings?
Sovereign and borrowing ratings also.
These two are actually different. When Modi governments, now we are doing, we are not doing. We don't have external, we have external commercial borrowings. We don't have external sovereign borrowings. We have sovereign borrowings within the country. That's what she was asking, sovereign bonds. There is 100% tax exemptions on sovereign bonds. We have public finance also, raising money from the public. So the problem here is, sovereign rating is required to attract FDIs. That is the only thing. Sovereign ratings given by S&P or whomsoever, they have been getting better and better in Modi's government. So he never leaves a capital related. We are slowly transforming to capital economy. Maybe we will have the style of Americans or Japanese or French or Britishers. That's what NDA government or Modi government or BJP government wants.
Well, I thought of actually, but since last 3-4 days, I am not reading any papers actually. I don't have time. Once I complete, then I will be able to.
Okay, we'll have one more search here.
Thank you for
thank you. But we are very thankful to Professor for making this arrangement. Thank you. And also the team of students who have assisted sir in this, also thanks to them. Thank you.
Maybe finally I should thank all of you. I think yesterday there was a team yesterday, I don't know how they came to me, how I went to me happened because of you guys. Raise your hands. Who were there yesterday? Yeah, these guys made it happen. It was a casual discussion we had, if you remember guys. We thought of doing it in an auditorium, but this number is okay. I didn't expect this much number. If not, we would have done it in auditorium itself. I personally thank Bhaskar sir to spare his precious time at the cost of his valuation and his services in other departments. And I hope we answered or I answered all your questions and queries. Is there anything left out? Yeah. Thank you once again.
Good afternoon everyone. I feel very privileged to conclude this session. First of all, I thank our college MBA department for arranging this session every year so that we can get a clarity of how our budget is planned. And yeah, this is the main point which has affected me because every sector has been clearly described here, and the question and answer session was also the main eye-catching thing, as the 100% of tax exemption to the sovereign wealth funds and the dividend distribution tax is also abolished. So these were some of the points which everyone doesn't know. But now after attending this session, we are like, everyone has known that how our financial minister Nirmala Sitharaman has been planned this Union Budget 2020. So I would personally thank on behalf of all our students to Indupuri sir and to Bhaskar sir that arranging the question and answer session is in a very effective manner. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you because you're holding your lunch.